afternoon baseball now from the home of the Mets, Citi Field in New York. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Oakland A's. Major League Baseball on the show is next. And now in the box, Brandon Lau. He will lead this one off today. Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. 65 degrees our temperature here at first pitch. Two balls and two strikes now. Fouled off. Here's another 2-2. On the changeup is taken for a called third strike, and the leadoff man is gone to begin the ball game. So one down, no one aboard, and here comes the five-tool middle infielder Wander Franco. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance, and this one is gone. A home run. Standing in now, G-Man Choi. High and deep down the left field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Another one sent foul. A little bouncer. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. Oh, there it goes. In the air to left center, and you can forget about this one. Back to back home runs. To the plate now, Nelson Cruz. Hard sinker misses 2-2. Still only one out in the inning. And there's a base hit on the line. In now, Austin Meadows. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. But he's going to get there as he runs it down on the warning track for the second out of the inning. Here's Randy Arozarena. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. And the 29th pitch of the inning is swung on and missed, and that'll finally end it. Now to the plate, Josh Harrison. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. It's 2-1 to the A's leadoff batter. Harrison in front, three balls and a strike.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit hard back up the middle. And this is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
Batting second, the center fielder, Starling.
Stepping in now, Starling Marte. Down low, two balls and a strike. And there's fires a line drive, base hit to left field.
That is good. The first baseman. Matt Olson.
At the plate now, Matt Olson. Swung on and missed that strike two. Ball two.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, one and two. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. First and second here with nobody out. Grounded weakly down the line toward third. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So one down with a pair of runners aboard. And striding into bat next, it would be Mark Canna. Now the payoff pitch home. And he misses with that one. Ball four. And that's going to load the bases now with still only one away. Next, it'll be Seth Brown. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses above the zone for a ball.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. He makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. Joey Wendell digs in now.
For me, this is an important add-on inning here. Their little lead is cute. I like it, but keeping the pressure on, building that lead, that's how you bury someone.
Marte is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. One out, nobody on. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Up next for the Rays, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Heading out towards shallow right. Brown is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Last half of the second set to go. And up next, the power hitting third baseman, Matt Chapman. The 1-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Now another 1-2. Lifted down the line in left. And that will end up a foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. So one out and nobody aboard. And that'll bring up the big-time power bat of right-handed hitter Chris Davis. Swung on and hammered. No doubt about this one. Watch it fly. And it's gone. So now to the plate, Tony Kemp. Fouled away. Once again, a 3-2. Now this ball's hit out to deep left center. Meadows moving back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he'll pull into second with one away. Into the box now, Sean Murphy. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. 3-1. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. And that'll bring up Josh Harrison, trying here to plate the tying run from second. The 1-1. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Franco takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out. Stepping in next, Starling Marte. He singled first time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. Gets the sign. The 2-1. Hit on the ground out to short. He's got it. Throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Brandon Lau. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2. Swing and a liner, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. So bases are empty with one gone. And in to swing the bat next is Wander Franco. Looking to drop one down, but he can't make contact. 1-2. Weak grounder back to the mound. And there's out number two. So two are gone here in the Tampa Bay third inning. And that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. The 1-1.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times or do I have to sit on something else?
And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Bottom of the inning now, and that brings in the big power hitting first baseman Matt Olson. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. So here's the cleanup hitter, Mark Canna. He drew a base on balls his first time up. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 1-2.
Yep, that ball went out.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Meadows will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. So now to the plate, Seth Brown. 0-for-1 here in the early going. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number three. Lays off the changeup and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Kiermaier able to track it down for the third out. Here's Nelson Cruz now. One and one, here it comes. Down the first baseline, and that's through for a hit. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Now back left field.
At the plate, Austin Meadows. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. But this is taken in on the warning track as the runner will tag from second. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Next to hit, Randy Arozarena, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Now a swing as he foul tips it here, and oh, right off his arm behind the plate. That hurts. A ball and two strikes. Here it is. Hits are now even at four apiece. A little low. It's two and two.
Two balls, two strikes.
In the dirt and blocked behind the plate, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Shot to third. Chapman's got it. And that's the second out. Now to the plate. Here is Joey Wendell, runner in scoring position with two gone. Ready with the 1-1. Line drive, base hit to right. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. To the plate now, Mike Zunino. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier flew out in his only at-bat so far. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting...
It's through. Let's see if they send him around to try to score. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily. Into the box, Brandon Lau. Called strike, and that'll run it full. And it's fouled away. Four runs, six hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that means Matt Chapman will dig in at the plate. 1-1. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Into the windup and the pitch. A breaking ball swung on and missed, and he's set down for the second time this afternoon.
Now batting.
One out, base is empty, and that'll bring up the big-time power bat of right-handed hitter. Base hit into right center.
The batter, number five, second baseman, Tony.
Standing in now, Tony Kemp. Popped him up. Zunino over to his right. Two gone. Two away now in the Oakland fourth. And that'll bring up Sean Murphy. One run, five hits, and no errors in the ballgame to the A's so far. A swing and a miss for the third strike as he went after what would have been ball four. Instead, the inning is over. All top of the fifth. And here comes the five-tool middle infielder, Wander Franco. This is pulled into right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard. So now to the plate, G-Man Choi. Two balls and a strike to the Rays' first baseman. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Nelson Cruz. He doubled his last time up. The 1-1.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and they get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ball game. Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Josh Fleming, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill.
Number 19.
Josh Harrison stands in. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Skied into very shallow right. Arozarena is in a few steps as he takes it for the first out. So one down, no one aboard. And that'll bring up Starling Marte. And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte.
Full count, 3-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him
today.
So it's a backwards K on the changeup that time. Starling Marte becomes out number two this inning. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And the pitcher will just run over and take this one himself, and the inning is over. Jace Caprillion takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 32.
So now into the box is Randy Arozarena. He'll lead things off for Tampa here in the sixth. Two and one. Caprillion is a guy that you'll notice attacks hitters with a high velocity slider. Not the old sweeper. He really fires it in there and snaps off big numbers.
3-1.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Now a ball hit high and deep down the left field line. This ball has a chance and gone for a home run. Stepping in now, Joey Wendell. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
One strike.
This is pulled into right. Brown is there, and he makes the catch for the out. So here's Mike Zunino. It was a walk in his last trip. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. And a fastball misses there, ball four. So here's Kevin Kiermaier, a hit and two tries for him so far.
Kevin.
3-2 pitch. Thank you. finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Now at the plate here is Brendan Lau, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. So here's the Oakland cleanup batter, Mark Canna. He flew out in his last AB. 1-1. Ripped down the line. A dive, but it's off his glove. And he won't risk the long throw across. He'll hang on to it. It's an infield single.
The right fielder, number 15.
At the plate now, Seth Brown. Now this is slowly hit to short, probably too slowly to get to. And he's safe. Into the box now, Matt Chapman. Grounded to third, this could be two. Reined in. One there, on to first to complete the double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And stepping in, the long ball threat, Chris Davis. The 1-1. Hard liner to center field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. That brings up Wander Franco. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. So stepping in is G-Man Choi. Here comes the 1-2. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. In here as he reaches to foul this one away. And he fouls this one off. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
Marte is there now, and he has it, two gone. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Thought this middle of the order might give him a fight and put up a little bit of resistance, but that hasn't been the case. He's carving right through them here.
2-2 the count. High and deep to left center field. Marte going back. And he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning.
Seventh inning stretch.
Into the box, Tony Kemp, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Now the 2-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
The 3-2 pitch. Into center field, line drive, base hit. So a good start to the inning for the A's as their leadoff hitter reaches base safely.
Now batting, the catcher, John.
In now, Sean Murphy. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
All you want is the leadoff man to get on to start a big inning, maybe get a big rally going to claw your way back into this ballgame.
Another full count pitch home. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Colin McHugh
comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number seven. Josh Harrison will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. So next to hit is Starling Marte. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled. He just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
Here's a fly ball. Well hit. Kiermaier on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Olson.
Here's a foul ball left side, and that'll move it to one and two. Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Popped him up. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to put this one away. Good reactions there, and the inning is over. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Meadows. 1-1. Started to chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And the count will be full. Drilled down the line. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Digging in next, Randy Arozarena. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point.
Going back to that last AB, that was the express. That was an upper 90s fastball that he turned around. So I think with this guy, you might want to try to incorporate some more off-speed pitches.
And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight. So next to bat will be Joey Wendell. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and striding into bat next, it'll be Mark Canna. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
The 3-1. And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eight.
Number 15.
Now it'll be Seth Brown. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Oh, and he leaves that one right over the plate as this is sent high and deep out to right center field. And it is gone, a home run. Andrew Kittredge is on the pitch here in the eighth with nobody out.
Number 36.
Standing in now, Matt Chapman. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
The designated hitter.
Now the A's designated hitter, Chris Davis. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Line hard toward right center. Again, a nice clean base hit, his third of the game. To the plate now, Tony Kemp. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Meadows moving back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Stepping up is Sean Murphy. A couple of walks for him thus far. 1-1.
We got two balls, one strike.
As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage. Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
And this one's in the dirt. Throw to third. And it's too late as he's in there. So now two men in scoring position. Runners at second and third with two gone. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. He pulls into second safely as two score on the play, and we are all tied up. J.P. Fireisen enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. So now to the plate, Starling Marte. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Zunino comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Here's the 3-1. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. Now with the plate is Kevin Kiermaier. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 1-1 home. One out, nobody on. Easy there, big fella. Two and two.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in, and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
To first. Oh, look at the sliding stop. The throw. Oh. Touché, sir. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Brandon Lau struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0 for 4 ball game right here. Count still full, 3 and 2. Hit pretty well out to deep left field. Racing back the left fielder. Gone! And with two out in the ninth, they have taken the lead. Here's Merrill Petit. Takes over now with two gone here in the top of inning number 9.
Number 26.
At the plate, Wander Franco. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Peter Fairbanks is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth. And that'll bring up Matt Olson. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-2 pitch. Hit hard to the right side. Scooped up. On to first, and that is a huge out to start the bottom of the ninth. Next up is Mark Canna, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. Now the 2-1 pitch. Popped him up. Wendell has a play. Two gone. Ready to take his hats again. Seth Brown blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Didn't stay on top of the slider that time as it misses high. Last strike now for Oakland. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. Into the box, Matt Chapman. Outside, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. And this is swung on and missed. So with that, they find themselves down to their final strike here this afternoon. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Count is full. Here's the pitch. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. To the plate now is the designated hitter, number 49. He's the last chance with the tying and winning runs on base and two men gone here in the ninth. And there's a called strike two as now they're down to their final strike this afternoon.
Now this guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Hard hit to first. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
A one-run game, 6-5, the final today. The Tampa Bay Rays came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. J.P. Feiereisen gets the W on the mound, so that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game: for the victorious Rays, 6 runs, 9 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Athletics, 5 runs, 12 hits, no errors. They left 12 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 29 minutes. Thank you.